Good morning, dear students. Welcome once again. This time we are going to discuss class 7, general knowledge, starting with the chapter number 47, plants. In this chapter, we are going to read about various phenomena of the plant, some of the interesting things like what is the function of root, stem, and all these things. Okay? So, first question is a dash is a large, thick root that grows. Through which this pollen tube penetrates. Okay, so it is a small opening in the surface of an ovule. Okay, third question, the tough protective outer sheath of the trunk, okay, the stem part of the plant, trunk, okay, so the protective outer covering of the trunk, branches of a tree is called bark. From the very beginning you know bark is the trunk part, which is a dead part. Okay, so tough protective outer sheath of the trunk is bark. Another question is, a dash is a type of stem used by climbing plants for support. So what do we call that type of stem which is used by climbing plants for support? It is tendril. Okay, so tendril is a type of stem. It is a stem only, tendril. Okay, it is a part of the stem used for climbing plants for support. You can see with the help of tendrils only plant can climb upon, right? So twigs, okay, that tendril is the part. Okay, another question, the age of a tree can be determined by looking at the dash. So age of a tree is determined by counting what? By counting annual rings. Always remember, okay? Annual rings. It is the annual ring. Here also it is written annual rings, okay? So it is the annual ring, okay, which determine the age of the tree, okay? So one annual ring grows in 1 year. So the number of annual rings is equal to the age of the tree. Okay. Another question. The uppermost branches of the tree in the forest forming a more or less continuous layer of foliage is called dash. You have seen, if you go into the forest and look at the top, you can see pony, you can see canopy. Okay. It seems as if all the trees are growing like this in a conical shape. Okay. That is canopy. So, it is the uppermost branches of the tree in the forest forming more or less continuous layer of foliage. Okay, so that is called canopy. Dash is the sugary fluid which is usually secreted within the flowers. What do we call that sugary fluid? Okay, which is usually secreted within the flowers? It is nectar. So nectar is the sugary fluid which is usually secreted within the flowers. Okay, right. A dash is a young tree, especially one with a slender trunk. So what do we call that young tree? The very young tree or small plants are called saplings. You might have learned in science. So it is the sapling which is young tree, especially one with the slender trunk. Okay, with the thin trunk, okay, with a narrow trunk, okay. So this is about the chapter number 47. Now coming on to the chapter number 48, only you have true and false. Okay, it is animal quiz. So all the facts and facets are about the animals. Bombay duck is the name of a fish found in India. So Bombay duck is the name of fish found in India. Is it true or false? Yes, it is true. So the name is Bombay duck, but it is a variety of fish that is found in India. Another question. Seahorses are horses that live in the sea. It is false. Seahorses are not the horses, but it is also a type of fish only. You can see the picture also, seahorse. Here only, okay? The picture of seahorse. Third question. Guinea pigs are not related to pigs. They are rodents. Yes, in the chapter of rodents, we have learned about the guinea pigs, right? So guinea pigs are not related to pigs. They are rodents, right? Yes. Now another question is, butterfly fish is a type of fish which is beautiful range of colors. That means butterfly fish is a type of fish with beautiful range of colors, mostly seen near coral reefs. Yes, very true. Butterfly fish is a type of fish with beautiful range of colors. Okay. Another question. Flying foxes are actually tree dwelling bats. So flying foxes are also bats. They are tree dwelling, tree living on trees. Okay. So they are tree dwelling bats. Flying foxes, always remember, flying foxes are bats which live on trees. Another question, jellyfish. You can also see the picture, jellyfish. Jellyfish are not actually fish, but small organisms that float in water. Yes, these are small organisms that float in water, and these are not actually fishes. Though the name is jellyfish, but these are not fishes, these are not fish. Okay. Ladybird is a type of bird. It is false. Ladybird is a insect that takes our blood, isn't it? So ladybird is not a bird. So ladybird is a type of bird is a false statement. Sea kraits are non-venomous snakes. False. Kraits are very venomous, very poisonous. Okay, always remember. So it is the sea kraits which are highly venomous snakes. Okay, so always remember these facts of true and false. Okay, moving on to the next chapter. Great explorers, everyone look into the book. Okay, of great explorers, here are some of the interesting, or you can say here are some of the facts of the explorers. One who does the voyage, one who keeps doing the journey on the ships. Okay, so these are famous for doing the journey on ships, and they have found out different countries also by exploring through the sea. Okay, though not the first to reach America from Europe, it was his voyage that led to general European awareness of the hemisphere and the successful establishment of European cultures in the New World. He made his voyage with 3 ships. So how you are going to get the clue about this voyager? By this last sentence. He made his voyage with the help of 3 ships. Santa Maria, Nina and Pinta. These are the 3 names of the ships with which he made the voyage. So he was Christopher Columbus, very famous voyager. So it was Christopher Columbus who made his voyage with 3 ships, Santa Maria, Nina and Pinta. Okay. Another question. A Portuguese born maritime explorer, he tried to find a westward route to the Spice Islands of Indonesia. So this explorer, he was Portuguese and he made a route to the Spice Islands of Indonesia. This voyage came to be known as first successful attempt at circumnavigation of the Earth, an important natural passage between Pacific and the Atlantic Oceans, is named after him. So, a natural passage, okay, in between the Pacific and Atlantic Ocean is also named after him. Moreover, he has made his journey to the Spice Islands of Indonesia. Okay, it was his first successful attempt at circumnavigation of the earth, that means circumference navigation. All together he sailed around the world. Okay, so he was Ferdinand Magellan. Okay, Ferdinand Magellan was the person who made his journey to the Spice Islands of Indonesia, and he was a Portuguese explorer. Okay, and a passage in between the Pacific and Atlantic Ocean is also named after him. Okay, next question. The first Englishman to successfully sail around the world. He is famous because he is the first Englishman to sail around the world successfully. His exploits were semi-legendary and made him a hero to the English, but to the Spaniards he was equated with the devil. He was Sir Francis Drake. Okay, he was Sir Francis Drake, who was the first Englishman to successfully sail around the world. That is the only key to this person, the first Englishman, okay, to successfully sail around the world. Okay, it made him a hero to the English. Okay, together with his father Niccolo and his uncle Matthew, this Venetian explorer was one of the first Westerners to travel the Silk Road to China and visit the great Kublai Khan. So he was the explorer who has traveled to Silk Road to China. Who was he? Moreover, he visited the great Kublai Khan. Okay, he was Marco Polo. Okay, so he was Marco Polo. He made his journey, traveled through the Silk Road to China and visited the great Kublai Khan. He was Marco Polo. Okay, another question. A Portuguese explorer who sailed around the southern tip of Africa in 1488. So this famous Portuguese explorer sailed around the southern tip of Africa in 1488, thus becoming the first European to do so. Okay, he originally named the Cape of Good Hope as the Cape of Storms. So he had named Cape of Good Hope as Cape of Storms. He was Bartolomeu Dias. Okay, Bartolomeu Dias was the explorer who named Cape of Good Hope as Cape of Storms, and he was first European to sail around the southern tip of Africa in 1488. Okay, these are the key features of Bartolomeu Dias. Okay, moving on to the next page, we have some more explorers. A Portuguese explorer, he was one of the most successful people in European age of discovery and the commander of first ships to sail directly from Europe to India. His body was first buried in India at St. Francis Church, Fort Kochi, but his remains were returned to Portugal in 1538. Who was he? He was Vasco da Gama. What is the key feature of this famous explorer? His body was buried in St. Francis Church in Kochi, Kerala. Okay, but his remains were returned to Portugal in 1538. Moreover, he was Portuguese explorer. Okay, and he was the commander of the first ships to sail directly from Europe to India. He was Vasco da Gama. Okay, moving on to the next question. Portuguese navigator, he was also Portuguese navigator and explorer, generally regarded as the first European discoverer of the sea. So he was the first European discoverer of the sea route to Brazil. So he is the European Portuguese explorer who was first European discoverer of sea route to Brazil. In Brazil, he is honored on a number of postage stamps and depicted on their currency. Who was he? He was Pedro Alvarez Cabral. Okay, so Pedro Alvarez Cabral was the discoverer of the sea route to Brazil. How to go to Brazil by sea? See, he was the founder of that, Pedro Alvarez Cabral. Okay. Another question: an Italian merchant explorer and cartographer. So he was merchant explorer, cartographer, as well as Italian merchant. He played a senior role in two voyages. He explored the east coast of South America between 1499 and 1502, and discovered that South America, extended much further south than previously known by Europeans. The new continent America was named after him. Yes, he was very famous in world history. He is Amerigo Vespucci. Amerigo Vespucci was the Italian merchant, explorer and cartographer. He played senior role in two voyages, explored in east coast of South America between 1499 and 1502, and discovered South America extended much further south than previously known by Europeans. So new continent America was named after him. He was Amerigo Vespucci. America is named after him only, Amerigo Vespucci. Number 9, a Norwegian explorer. He led the first successful Antarctic expedition between 1910 and 1912. He was also the first ever person to successfully traverse the Northwest Passage, a sea route through the Arctic Ocean along the northern coast of North America, connecting the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. He was Roald Amundsen. Norwegian explorer successfully made an expedition between 1910 to 1912 where? Antarctic. Antarctic, and he was also the first ever person to successfully traverse the Northwest Passage. So he was Roald Amundsen. Last but not the least, the French navigator who first explored and described the Gulf of Saint Lawrence and shores of Saint Lawrence River. So he is a French navigator, French explorer, who explored St. Lawrence Gulf and St. Lawrence River, named Canarta, which is now Canada. So he explored Canada. He was Jacques Cartier, J-A-C-Q-U-E-S-C-A-R-T-I-E-R, Jacques Cartier, So he was Jacques Cartier. So this is about your explorers. Moving on to the next, we have Nobel Prize winner, very interesting chapter. Who are these fellows? Who has won the Nobel Prize in which field? This is very important. First, name the Polish scientist who won the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1903 for her work on radiation, and followed it up with the Nobel Prize for Chemistry in 1911 for her work on radium. Very famous. Who discovered radium? It was Marie Curie, Madame Curie. You might have read about her in Hindi book also, right? So she was Madame Curie, Marie Curie, who was Polish scientist, that means belonging to Poland, and won the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1903 for work on radiation, and then won the Nobel Prize for Chemistry for work on radium, right, which is used for curing cancer, right? So she is Marie Curie, who won the Nobel Prize for Physics as well as Chemistry for the work on radiation and radium respectively. Which international organization has won the Nobel Peace Prize on three occasions? In 1917, 1944 and 1963. So what is the name of the organization that won three Nobel Peace Prize? 1917, in 1944 also, and in 1963 also. It is International Committee of Red Cross. International Committee of Red Cross has won the Nobel Peace Prize in three occasions. Always remember, okay? Yes. Another question. In 2016, who won the Nobel Prize in Literature for having created new poetic expressions within the great American song tradition? So who won the Nobel Prize in Literature in the year 2016? It was Bob Dylan, created new poetic expressions within the great American song tradition. For creating new poetic expression, he has won the Nobel Prize in Literature. Okay, it was Bob Dylan. Okay. Another question. He won the Nobel Prize for Chemistry in 1954 and received the Nobel Peace Prize in 1962. Name the famous scientist. It is Linus Pauling. So Linus Pauling won the Nobel Prize for Chemistry, and he also won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1962. Okay, Linus Pauling. Okay, P-A-U-L-I-N-G. Linus Pauling is the person who won the Nobel Prize for Chemistry in 1954 and received the Nobel Peace Prize in 1962. Okay, yes. Moving on to the next. Who is the only person to win the Nobel Prize for Physics twice? So name the person who win the Nobel Prize for Physics twice. Once for inventing the transistor and the other time for theory of superconductivity. Who is the person who won the Nobel Prize for Physics twice? First time he got the Nobel Prize for inventing transistor and another time for theory of superconductivity. He was John Bardeen. So John Bardeen is the person. Okay, yes. Moving on to the next page, we have some more Nobel Peace Prize winners. Which famous French author declined the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1964? That means he refused to take the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1964. He was Jean-Paul Sartre. Okay, Sartre. Jean-Paul Sartre was the person who declined. Okay, he declined his Nobel Prize for Literature in the year 1964. He was Jean-Paul Sartre. Okay. Another question. Name the novelist who declined the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1958 under pressure from his government and had his book published in his homeland in 1988. He was Boris Pasternak. Okay. So Boris Pasternak was the novelist who declined the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1958 because of pressure of the government, and he made his book got published in homeland in 1988. Okay. Now very famous question. Which Pakistani youth icon received the Nobel Peace Prize jointly with Kailash Satyarthi in 2014? She was Malala Yousafzai. So Malala Yousafzai has the name as the Nobel Peace Prize winner, won jointly with Kailash Satyarthi in the year 2014. Okay, yes. Another question coming to your way. Who was the first US president to win a Nobel Peace Prize? So you have to name the first US president to win a Nobel Peace Prize. He was Theodore Roosevelt. Yes, he was Theodore Roosevelt, who was the first US president to win a Nobel Peace Prize. He was Theodore Roosevelt. Okay, clear? Yes. Another question. Which legendary campaigner for peace was nominated 5 times but never won the Peace Prize? So who was that campaigner for peace who has nominated for 5 times but not won the Nobel Prize, not won the Peace Prize for even a single time? And there is a hint also. In 1948, the year of his death, the Nobel Committee, realizing its folly, did not award the Peace Prize to anyone. In his honor, nobody has been awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in that year, in 1948, when he died. He was none other than our very own Mahatma Gandhi. Okay. So So our great leader, the father of our nation, has been nominated for 5 times but has never won the Nobel Prize. Okay, Nobel Peace Prize, you can say, right? Now another question coming to your way. Which region, in 2009, Elinor Ostrom became the first woman to win the Nobel Prize in which category? So in 2009, Elinor Ostrom was the first woman to win the Nobel Prize. For which category or in which field she won the Nobel Prize? It was economics, in the field of economics. Okay? Yes. Another question. Name the Bangladeshi economist who won the Nobel Peace Prize in 2006. So you have to name the Bangladeshi economist who won the Nobel Peace Prize in 2006 along with Grameen Bank, which he had founded. That means he was Bangladeshi economist, won the Nobel Peace Prize in the year 2006. Okay? Along with his Grameen Bank, which he has founded. That means he is the founder of Grameen Bank. So question may be asked, who is the founder of Grameen Bank? It was Muhammad Yunus. Okay? So Muhammad Yunus was the Bangladeshi economist who won the Nobel Peace Prize in 2006 along with Grameen Bank. Here are some of the awardees which are given at the list, in the list also. Rabindranath Tagore won literature for literature in the year 1913. C.V. Raman has won the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1930. And several names are there who belongs to our country, okay? Including Hargobind Khurana, Mother Teresa was also there. S. Chandrasekhar is there. Amartya Sen is there, okay? Kailash Satyarthi was there, okay? So these are the famous Indians who have won Nobel Prize in different fields. Okay. So now it's time to note down your homework. Your homework will be same. You have to learn all these chapters. You have to learn from 47, chapter number 47 to 50. Okay. This will be your homework. Next time when I am going to come, I am going to come up with more interesting facts and figures. Till then, stay at home, stay healthy, stay blessed. Have a nice day, have a wonderful day.